city of Matera in the Basilicata region of southern Italy is one of two cities that have been selected as 2019's European Capital of Culture.
Grazie.
Prego, prego.
Buongiorno Margherita, welcome, nice to see you.
Grazie Michele. Michele Centonze is the Director of Sales and Marketing at the fabulous Sextantio Le Grotte della Civita.
Oh my God, I'm speechless.
Oh, this is going to be my home.
Yes, it will be your home.
It's so beautiful.
Everything is coming from the past. That's linens, of course.
I'm just so looking forward to the experience. Grazie, Michele.
Grazie a te. Enjoy, Margherita. Enjoy
Grazie.
Your stay.
A room in a cave and breakfast with a view. What more can a girl ask for?
Good morning from Sextantio in Matera. Buongiorno to all of you. This is just absolute magic.
Across Sextantio is the spectacular Murgia Park, an even more ancient part of Matera. If you look closely enough, you will see caves carved out of the stone mountain.
And look at this, I can even have my own freshly cracked walnuts. This is a beautiful bruschetta made with Matera bread. And Matera bread is one of the DOP breads from Italy. They're super known for it, and you can have it actually grilled or not grilled, but I like it as a bruschetta. And of course, I'm going to have it with just a little bit of burrata. Ooh, grazie. Grazie, signora. Did you see that? The burrata just oozed out. Yummy. This is the best area for burrata. So, I mean, what an enjoyable thing to be able to have a beautiful little fresh one for breakfast. I have to toast to the heavens and say thank you for this wonderful, wonderful gift.
For a first timer to Matera, I do recommend that you get a tour guide.
Hi.
Ciao.
Hi, hi. Stefania, nice to meet you.
Me too, my pleasure.
Unlike other Italian cities, Matera is not as popular yet, so English-speaking tour guides are few and far between. Matera was once the shame of Italy, and with Stefania telling me the story, I understand it more. She tells me Matera was once one of the most desolate parts of Italy. And in 1993, it was designated a UNESCO World Heritage Site. Today, Matera is undergoing a renaissance as its once abandoned caves are being converted into shops, art galleries, restaurants, and hotels. In the middle of all the activity going on, are fossil remains frozen in time.
There is a sea sponge. Look how many here coming out.
All the shells.
And the sands. This is all sands.
This suggests that the entire city of Matera was underwater some 2 million years ago.
Matera, if we see Matera from the top, has got a particular shape. Looks like a bird, like a pigeon.
Oh.
Where the body is represented by the cathedral, instead okay. The two wings are the two districts called Sassi.
The Sassi, or the oldest part of Matera, is a winding maze of streets and houses with no clear beginning or end. To orient yourself, look for the highest spot, Civita Hill, on which the Cathedral of Santa Maria della Bruna stands. The cathedral was built in the Romanesque Apulian style between 1230 and 1270. From any vantage point, Matera looks like the perfect movie set. And it's no wonder that so many movies have been filmed here. James Bond, I hear, is filming as we speak.
Oh. You know that Mel Gibson came here?
Yeah, The Passion of Christ.
The Passion of Christ, and is coming again in a few months to do the sequel of The Passion.
Oh.
And there, I've done 3 years ago, the revisitation of Ben Hur with Morgan Freeman, and the beginning of Wonder Woman, and Maria Magdalena are the last movies that I've done
in this area.
Yeah.
Thank you so much for showing me the heart of Matera. It means so much to me. It's been a really, really fulfilling and heartwarming experience.
Michele Castelli and Virginia Caravita are a match made in kitchen heaven. These are the young chefs behind the highly imaginative Dimura Ulmo in Matera. Both protégés of Massimo Bottura, they bring experience and creativity with them to Dimura Ulmo. Dimura Ulmo is a restored palazzo in the middle of the Sassi. It's a mix of classic and modern, with high arched ceilings painted in ornate fashion and modern art completing the look. Step outside to a beautiful stone terrace to enjoy a spectacular 360-degree view. Their cuisine is a modern twist on local ingredients and recipes from the region of Basilicata. The ingredients Michele and Virginia have chosen to work with today are bacala, or cod, black chickpeas, and Cusco pepper.
Cod skin, dried also, and milk.
And milk.
Yeah, exactly. Now Michele is cleaning the cod and he's keeping away the belly of the cod. And also he will keep away the skin.
Just like most Italian dishes, guarda, only 5 ingredients. Very simple, no?
Absolutely, yes. We think that kitchen has to be simple, but with very high quality ingredients. So
exactly.
I'm surprised to discover that cod is a common ingredient in the mountains of Basilicata.
And now we have to put them in the dryer.
And look at that, waste nothing, no?
No, nothing.
You have to use everything.
Yeah, exactly.
The cod skin goes into the dehydrator and will remain there for 3 days at 60 degrees.
Please, come here to cut.
Okay.
You have to help us.
I have to earn my meal, so I help out with the kitchen prep. The cod goes into a pot and is covered with milk.
When it will start to boil, we will switch it off because the fish has not to be overcooked, but it has to remain soft.
The next ingredient is black chickpeas, or cecineri, very common in the area. Just cover in water and add olive oil.
And loro.
The chickpeas need a couple of hours on the stove to soften.
Ah, so this is the finished product of the...
Just put a little bit of salt.
Okay.
And stop.
That's the dehydrated cod skin being deep fried.
Crocante.
Yes. Now it's so crispy.
Oh, and now the peppers.
Just in the paper.
Okay.
Because if you put in the water after,
it's
very, very
dangerous.
when you fry. Whoa. Ooh la la.
It becomes
like a balloon.
The cod is done. And together with some milk and just a little salt, it is transferred to the mixer. The leftover milk, Michele says, will be used to boil pasta. To create a cod mousse, olive oil is added to the milk and cod mixture.
Oh my gosh.
Do you want to try?
Yes. The flavor of the pepper is so intense but sweet.
And it's not spicy.
No,
absolutely.
The bacala mantecato is done.
Wow.
And after, it has to rest a little bit because all the ingredients has to mix
together.
Exactly.
It may be a recipe with only 5 ingredients, but it's the best 5 ingredients available. Not to mention the meticulous preparation that went into making this dish. From dehydrating the skins of the cod to boiling the black beans for hours, to creating a cod mousse, and to frying up those beautiful pepperoncini Cusco, it's science, technique, and restraint.
Wow! Thank you. This is our bacala mantecato that we made earlier. I'm so excited to try it. Flavor of the bacala, so delicious and creamy, and the cecchi as well.
Qué delicioso. Chin chin.
There's a Salvador Dali exhibit, and it's part of the many activities celebrating the city being named 2019's European Capital of Culture. I'm so thankful I'm seeing Matera now, while it's still, in a way, Italy's best-kept secret.